Hello, Cresswell. My name is Richard Zetterball, and this is the Mayor's COVID-19 message for May 18th, 2020. I'd like to begin by saying that I'm not overly comfortable as a public speaker. I do my best. I may stumble at times, but bear with me. This information is extremely important. So let's begin. In this video, I'll be discussing several topics that will range from national, state, county, and local levels. At this time, the number of cases nationally has exceeded 1.5 million, and over 90,000 Americans have died from the COVID-19 virus. The latest projections from the University of Washington project that over 147,000 Americans could lose their lives by early August. Never in our lifetimes have we experienced such suffering and death and pain by any cause in such a short span of time. Seeing numbers like these is truly unbelievable and heart-wrenching. I simply cannot comprehend the pain and sorrow that so many American families have had to endure because of this terrible disease and pandemic. Oregon, however, is very fortunate. We have not suffered those severe health impacts like many other areas of the country. This is in part due to the guidance of Governor Kate Brown. She acted strongly and swiftly with physical distancing, executive orders, and her Stay at Home to Save Lives campaign. So far, Oregon has tested over 92,000 people, and of those, 3,500 or so have tested positive. Sadly, 137 Oregonians have lost their lives. My heart goes out to each and every one of their families. Part of what the governor talked about is for Oregonians to continue to work hard and follow the phase one reopening guidance. We have to remember that a reopened business is only one infection away from being a closed business, and that is not what any of us wants. That would be truly sad. So let's pledge to work together and control the things that we can control. Those include 6-foot physical distancing, frequent hand washing, and wearing masks when you're not able to maintain the 6-foot physical distancing rule. So let's do our part to not be that one person that could cause a Cresswell business to be forced to close. That would be truly devastating for all of us, especially for the business owners. Despite what you may think, the virus is truly in our community. So let's do our parts together. Our continued success to keep the community and the country moving forward will help Lane County and Cresswell businesses continue to open. With this continued success, it could lead to Lane County being approved for phase two reopening guidance. That's what we all want. Keep moving forward. So, please wear your masks when within 6 feet of other people, and don't worry about how you think it makes you look. You're doing your part for our continued success. Most businesses now, employees will be required to wear masks. So please be understanding and patient with them. Put yourself in their shoes and empathize with the difficulties that they are facing. They are there to serve the needs of our community and are working on the front lines for us. Some of them could feel embarrassed if the customers are not wearing masks. That's just the fact, sadly. Nobody knows also that they are an asymptomatic carrier, so please wear your mask and prevent infections. Do your part for the safety of our community and for our continued success of our city and our country. We simply cannot go backwards. So let's talk more about phase one reopening guidance that was announced by Governor Kate Brown on May 14, 2020. So there have been several prerequisites that every county has had to document prior to moving forward with phase one reopening. These include declining prevalence of COVID-19 cases, meeting the minimum testing requirements, contact tracing capacity, having sufficient healthcare capacity, have sufficient PPE, which is personal protective equipment, have ways to isolate and quarantine people who cannot self-isolate, and declining numbers of people who require hospitalization. During the minimum 21-day period between phase one and phase two, it will require continued testing, contact tracing, and a decline in cases and hospitalizations. Several sector guidances have been released. They include the following categories: retail stores, outdoor recreation, restaurants, bars, brew pubs, and tasting rooms, and personal services, which includes hair salons, nail salons, tattoo parlors, and the like. There are additional sectors that are continuing to be reviewed and will be released by the governor's office when they are. Links to the governor's COVID-19 phase one guidance and the approved sectors can be found at the Oregon coronavirus webpage, which can be located at oregon.gov/coronavirus. This link has been posted on the city's webpage as well as the city's Facebook page. The economic losses and damage to our economy has been terrible and devastating. We all know that. We all know people who have lost their lives or had businesses shuttered. We all need to continue the progress towards phase two reopening. If the rates of hospitalization or cases were to spike, it could cause the return of shutting down of our economy right when we are making progress that we all want and that we all need. So let's pledge to work together to keep the cases and hospitalization rates declining. Going backwards is simply not an option. That would be the worst case scenario for all of us. There are no pain-free options to consider when reopening our economy. The goal is to open slowly and do so in a manner that is most sustainable and won't lead towards shutting down businesses again. At the May 11, 2020 City Council meeting, the City Council approved the creation of a microloan grant program to help Crestville businesses who have been suffering from the impacts of this crisis. The City Council approved $30,000 from the fiscal year 1920 budget that was not used to fill a staff position in City Hall. The City Council also approved $50,000 if the Lane County application to Business Oregon were to be approved. In the Lane County application, collectively, the cities of the local area are requesting up to $750,000. If approved, Crestville will be eligible for an additional $50,000 in a dollar-for-dollar match in grant funds and a possible total of $100,000 for Crestville businesses. That would be fantastic. So keep our fingers crossed. Lane County has ramped up the testing and contact tracing capacity. This will provide the county the opportunity for a much clearer picture and the account of the county's infection rates going forward and moving towards phase two reopening. In the state, over 420,000 unemployment insurance claims have been filed, with a bit over 90% have been processed. Needless to say, the Employment Department phones and online systems has been under a very heavy load. Over 200 people have been hired at the Unemployment Department to help process the excessive number of claims and the remaining applications. Fortunately, the vast number of people who do qualify for unemployment also qualify for the additional $600 weekly benefit from the CARES Act funding. We should all feel blessed that we live in Lane County of Oregon. We have been spared the worst health impacts that have happened to many other parts of the country. We live in one of the lowest confirmed case areas of the entire country. In Lane County, there are 63 confirmed cases and 2 deaths. In zip code 97426, between 1 and 9 cases of COVID-19 have been confirmed, and there are no deaths in that zip code area. Nationally, cases are beginning to flatten in many areas. As our country begins to reopen, infections and cases will increase and could remain high in certain areas for some time. Let's all do our part not to let that happen in Lane County, and especially here in Crestville. We need to keep up the good work and continue to do our parts to curb the spread of this awful virus so that our businesses that have reopened and in the area can stay open. Our health experts tell us that we need to get used to this some form of physical distancing for the foreseeable future. They tell us the only things that can bring a dramatic change will to this will be a cure for COVID-19 or a vaccine created that can be administered to the entire population. Our reopening is not the light at the end of the tunnel, but are the first steps towards seeing the faint glimmers of light at the end of the tunnel. The good news is that we're moving forward. We have a strategy, we have a guidance, and we're moving towards reopening. This will enable Lane County and Crestwell businesses the opportunity to reopen. We can finally begin to go back to work, do some shopping, and begin a very slow process of recovery. We are all in this together. If we continue to do our parts, we can keep moving forward one day at a time and one day closer to phase two reopening of Oregon guidance. Finally, thank you, Crestwell. You continue to make me proud. You are strong, you are staying strong, and you're doing what's necessary to get us through the worst health crisis of our lifetimes. Stay safe, stay healthy, and stay strong, Crestwell, and remember, this too shall pass. Thank you. Mayor Z out.